Dear student, today I am going to deliver a lecture on production technology of onion. Onion is one of the most important vegetable crops grown in India. The total area under this crop in India is about 1.31 million hectare, and production and productivity is about 20.93 million tons and 17.3 million 3000 ton. The area under production is Maharashtra, Karnataka, Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh. The onion is herbaceous, annual for the edible bulb production and biennial for the seed production, having bisexual flower, and is a highly cross pollinated crop. The flower is an umbel. It is pollinated by bees and other insects. The reason for cross pollination is heteromorphism and male sterility. Flowers are protenders and the edible portion is modified stem called bulb. This is known as scaly leaves and develops underground. Its pungency is due to the presence of volatile oil called allyl propyl disulfide or diallyl disulfide. It is also known as sulfur compound. Its red color is because of anthocyanin, and yellow color is due to quercetin. Quercetin is a thin layer of the surrounding the onion bulb. Antifungal activities is in onion is due to phenolic factor catechol. The leaves are yellowish and bluish green in grow, and this is the 30% area and production are in Maharashtra, however 23% in Karnataka. Maximum onion production takes place in Maharashtra, is about 4,900 and 5,000 tons, but in Karnataka 2,500 and 92,000 ton are to be found. These are the different, these has different species are found in onion. Allium sepa, variety sepa. It is a common onion with large bulb, borne slightly and propagated through seeds. And next one is Allium sepa, variety aggregatum. This is the multiplier onion, are known as potato onion, producing a small bulb, born in clusters and generally propagated through small bulbs. Allium sepa variety Escalonium, it is produced bulb in clusters and surface of the soil. This perennial onion rarely produced seeds and it is propagated through bulbs, also called salad. And next one is Allium sepa variety Viviparum or Prolifera, not widely cultivated, but bulbs are produced in place of umbels and are used for pickling and seasoning, also called tree onion. And next species are Allium Sconoperum or Chives. This is an hardy perennial bunching herbs, is grown for their hollow green leaves. It is propagated by root division. Allium fistulosum, it is a perennial bunching species and is a very common in China and Japan, and is grown for its edible tops and leaf base. Next one is, what are the major importance of the onion in human being? So then the green leaves and immature and mature bulb are eaten raw and used in preparation for sauce, soup and seasoning of the foods on account of its special characteristics of pungency. Used in processed form, that is flake, powder and pickles, onion are diuretic, applied on bruises, boils and wound. Relieves heat sensation. Bulb juice is used as smelling on hysterical fits and faintness. these are the different nutritive value are different elements, and the moisture contents are found in onion bulb contains 100 grams of edible portion is about 86.6 gram moisture are found, and there are different vitamins, proteins, minerals are found in the onion bulb. The area and its distribution is most important. Before I told you, the onion is commercially cultivated in India for vegetable and spices purpose. India ranks second in area and production in the world after China, and third in export after the Netherlands and Spain. In India, it is cultivated in a large area, 13.05 lakh hectare, with a total production is about 20.93 million tons, and productivity is 17.3 tons per hectare. Among the different states, Maharashtra is a leading state in the terms of area and production. In Uttar Pradesh, it is grown in about 0.0254 million hectare, with the production of 0.423 million tons. This data was recorded by NHRD of 2016 and 2017. Next one is variety. The different varieties and important varieties of the onion is first one is red variety. Different red variety are found in onion crop. First, Pusa red. Whatever Pusa red variety is about plants mature in 145 days after transplanting. The TSS is about 12 and 13%. Average yield is 25 tons per hectare and suitable for export purpose. Next one is Punjab selection. Bulbs are quite firm with the good keeping quality, and the TSS is about 14%. Average yield is 20 tons per hectare, and Pusa Ratnar is a plant mature 125 days after transplanting, and TSS is about 11 to 12%. Average yield 30 tons per hectare, and these are the variety I recommended for rabi cultivation. And Kalyanpur Red Round, it is a popular variety of the Uttar Pradesh, and introduced by C.S. Azad University of Agriculture and Technology, Kanpur. TSS is 13 to 14% and plant mature 150 to 60 days from the date of sowing, and average productivity or yield is about 25 to 30 tons per hectare are found. And Arkaniketan is the variety which introduced by IAHR Bangalore, and it is mature in 145 days after transplanting, and the average yield is about 34 tons per hectare. Arka Pragati is also introduced in IAHR Bangalore, and the variety has attractive pink color, and maturity is about 140 to 145 days after sowing, and the yield is about 25 to 30 tons per hectare. And the Punjab Red Round, it is early maturing and high yielding variety. It is also produced productivity is about 30 tons per hectare. Pusa Meghvi, Madhvi, maturity is about 45 days after transplanting. The average yield potential is 30 tons per hectare. This is also, these are the varieties are recommended for rabi cultivation. And second one is white onion variety, the Pusa White Round. It has 12 to 13%. TSS and drying ratio is 8:1, and crop maturity is 130 to 135 days after transplanting, and yield potential is about 32.5 tons per hectare. It is also a good keeping quality. It's have a good keeping quality, and Pusa white flat bulb are very attractive and white in color, flat is round with 12-14% TSS, and the plant maturity is about 130-135 days after transplanting, and this is a good storage, have a good storage quality. Punjab 48, it is very good texture and flavor, suitable for dehydration, good for storage, and productivity is about 30 tons per hectare. Phule Safed and Agri Found White, these are the TSS is about 14-15%, good keeping quality, and plant maturity is or plant length is high, 160-165 days after sowing. Average yield is about 20-25 tons per hectare. These are the all the varieties are Rabi crop, and the next one is yellow color variety. Early Grano is yellow color crop. Maturity is 95-110 days, and TSS is very low, 6-7%, poor in storage, and average yield is about 50-60 tons per hectare. The Spanish Brown is TSS 13-14%, crop maturity is 160-180 days, and ready for harvesting during August-September, and average yield is about 28-30 tons per hectare. Arka Pitambar is introduced by IHR Bangalore, and short duration variety, globe shaped yellow bulb, average bulb weight is 80 gram, moderately resistant to purple blotch, and yield is about 35-38 tons per hectare. This is all the varieties are in Kharif season, and next one is Rabi season, and next crop is Kharif season variety. Agri Farm Dark Red is a Kharif variety. It has TSS is 12-13%, and plant maturity is about 95-110 days after transplanting. The yield potential is about 30-40 tons per hectare. Bhima Super is a red onion variety introduced by Directorate of Onion and Garlic Research, Pune, Maharashtra, has released for Kharif season. It can also be grown in late Kharif. It is reported to have an average yield is about 22 tons per hectare in Kharif, and 40-45 tons per hectare in Rabi crop. And N53, it has a TSS is about 11-12%, and poor keeping quality, ready for harvest in 90-100 days after transplanting, and average yield is 25 tons per hectare. It is suitable for export purpose and grown in Rabi and Kharif both season. And Baswant 780 variety is 11-12% TSS, keeping quality is very poor, ready for harvest in 90-100 days after transplanting, and average yield is about 25-30 tons per hectare. It is also suitable for Kharif season in Maharashtra. This variety is suitable in Maharashtra, especially Bhima Raj is the mature within 120-125 days after transplanting, with absolutely no bolters, with average yield range from 25-30 tons per hectare. And Bhima Super is a very popular variety. It is reported to have an average yield of 20-22 tons per hectare in Kharif, and 40-45 tons per hectare in late Kharif. Bulbs attain maturity within 100-105 days after transplanting in Kharif, and 110-120 days after in late Kharif. So these are the Kharif season variety, and mostly variety introduced by Directorate of Onion and Garlic Research in Pune. And next one is climate. What are the climate requirement for onion crop? The onion is a cool season crop. Onion can be grown under wide range of climatic condition. It grows well under mild climate without extreme heat or cold of the excessive rainfall. For good over vegetative growth, 12.8% to 23% degree centigrade temperature before bulbing, and for bulb development 22-25 degree centigrade are required. Very low temperature is the beginning, results in bolting. Then kharif onion varieties require day length of 10 to 11 hours, whereas rabi variety relatively higher temperature and 12 to 13 hour of the day length. Temperature is more important than day length in seed production, while photoperiod is more important than temperature for bulb production. So though the climatic requirement of the onion crop is very important for productivity, production and vegetative growth. Next one is soil. What are the requirement of the soil for onion? Onion prefers grow well and form good size of the bulb in light soil, rich in humus, thrive well drained with the ability to the retain soil moisture. Avoid always to heavy soils for onion cultivation. For obtaining higher yields, care should be taken that onion is not planted in soil having high acidity and alkalinity. The optimum range of the pH is 5.8 to 6.5 for almost all cultivars except Hisar 2 and Punjab Selection, which are salt tolerance. So these are the soil requirement. And next one is how we can grow nursery or nursery practices. What are the practices for nursery growing? So onion seed is generally sown in raised nursery bed of 15 to 22 centimeter height, and the width of the nursery bed should be 0.45 meter in length, can be kept 3 to 4 meters. The surface of the bed should be smooth and well leveled. The soil of the nursery should be treated with thirum or kapton at the rate of 0.2% or 4 to 5 gram per square meter area. Before sowing, seeds should be treated with thirum at the rate of 2 to 3 gram per kg of seed to avoid damage from damping of diseases. Sowing should be done in line spaced at 5 to 7 centimeter distance. The seeds after sowing should be covered with fine powdered farmyard manure or compost, followed by light watering by rose can. The bed should be covered with dry grass or straw or sugar cane leaves to maintain required temperature and moisture. Then next one is seed sowing time. What are the best time for nursery sowing or seed sown in our nursery bed? The best time for sowing of seed for early kharif crop is April May. The sowing of the early rabi or late kharif in September and October. In August and September in Maharashtra, and normally for rabi crop sowing in done in September and October in South, November and December in Maharashtra and part of the Gujarat, and October November in North and Northeastern part. The rabi sowing in hills is done September October, and for summer long day type October and early November. And the seed rate and the spacing of the onion is 10 to 12 kg per hectare for rabi and 12 to 15 kg per hectare for kharif crop. Best time for transplanting for kharif crop is July-August, while for rabi crop is December and January. The nursery will be ready for transplanting when plants are 6 to 7 weeks old, and for kharif 8 to 9 weeks old. For common big size onion, the spacing is kept 15 cm from row to row and 10 cm from plant to plant. For a small picking onion, 8 into 5 cm has been recommended if crop is raised by transplanting method. Irrigation. Next one is irrigation. Irrigation is most essential and most important practice for the production of onion crop. First, just after transplanting of seedling, light irrigation is essential. Subsequent irrigations should be given as per need of the crop. The quality of the water and its frequency of application depends on the crop growth, soil types, planting season, etc. Irrigation should be withheld 15 to 20 days before commencement of the maturity. Otherwise, it will delay the maturity and reduce the quality of the bulb. Critical stages for irrigation in onion are bulb formation and enlargement stages. The irrigation during this period should be attended to carefully. The splitting of the outer scale may be observed when dry spell is followed by the irrigation. And the next one is manures and fertilizer. Manures and fertilizer is essential and most important for the crop, and doses is very proper because there are different disorder are found if the imbalanced dose of fertilizer taken to the crop. About 2000 to 2050 quintal of farmyard manure should be incorporated during the field preparation, and nitrogen at 60 to 80 kg, phosphorus 40 to 50 kg, and potassium 60 to 80 kg per hectare are required for higher yields. Application of whole dose of phosphorus and potassium and half dose of nitrogen is done just before transplanting, and the remaining half dose of nitrogen should be treated or should be trap dressed about 25 to 30 days after transplanting when seedlings are well established and growing. Next, practices weeding and interculture operation. Weeding weeds are to be kept down to get a good yield of onion. Onion is a poor competitor of weeds. Weeds are controlled by Terenon at the rate of 2.5 kg per hectare at 3 to 5 weeks after transplanting. Application of Vaseline 1 liter per hectare immediately after transplanting help control. The weeds stomp at the rate of 3.35 liter per hectare applied immediately after transplanting. Before first irrigation, with one hand weeding gives the best result. Application of 0.2% oxychloroplane, 23.5% EC before planting, plus one hand weeding at 40 to 60 days after transplanting is recommended for marketable bulb yield, and weed control efficiency is 65 to 80%. This recommendation is recommended by Directorate of Onion Garlic Research, Pune. And next one is harvesting. Harvesting practice of onion depends on the type and purposes. Different types. One is onion for greens, or harvesting for green onion. the purposes of this type of onion is to get high quality green leaves. Plants are pulled when bulb formation are start. And next one is immature bulb. As per need for the consumption and supply to the market, immature onion plants are pulled along with the bulbs. And next one is mature bulb. When bulbs become fully mature, the maturity is indicated by drooping of the tops just above the bulb, known as neck fall stage. The tops may be made down manually before 8 to 10 days of the harvesting. The harvesting is done by pulling the bulbs. Help of khurpi may be taken. On large scale, modified potato digger can be used. In kharif crop, in case of onion, physiological maturity are not found, or you know that the physical physiological maturity of the onion crop is not attained, and the crop is a neck fall stage. The yield, next one is the yield. The average yield of big size common onion is 25 to 30 tons per hectare, and small size common onion is 16 to 20 tons per hectare, and multiplier onion is 15 to 18 tons per hectare. In kharif onion, 15 to 20 tons per hectare of yield can be obtained, but the seed yield is 6 to 8 quintal per hectare in case of bulb to seed method, and 8 to 10 quintals in case of seed to seed method. However, we can we told you before different varieties, what are the varieties and what are the characteristics, major production productivity and other characters have been discussed to the different onion crops. And next is the curing of the onion bulb. Curing is an essential operation after harvesting. It will remove excess moisture from the outer skin and neck of the onion bulb. Curing increases storage life of the onion bulbs. Not only this, curing helps in improving the color of the skin. Properly cured onion will have tight skin and well-dried outer skin. Usually 10 to 15 days or so will be sufficient for curing the onion bulb. And this is the next one is insect pest and diseases. What are the insect and diseases are affect the onion crop? So insect are onion thrips, is known as thrips tabaci. Affected leaves shows silvery white blotches, which later become brownish. Spring summer crop affected much by thrips. A long spell of the dry weather is favorable for its rapid multiplication, whereas heavy rains and humid weather adversely affect its development and multiplication. The control measure of the onion thrips is collect the debris, affected leaves and weeds, and destroy them, and follow crop rotation. In the area where thrips infestation is severe, grow resistant varieties like Nasik Red and Spanish White. Apply 4-10 g at 1 kg per hectare and control the onion thrips. Next one is onion maggots. Onion maggots, Hylemia antiqua. It attacks the tender portion of the bulb remain hidden in the base and plant and the cracks of the soil where they also be lay the eggs. Affected plants become yellow to brown and later they dry away. Control measure, soil application of Thimate 10G is beneficial. Spray Melathion at 0.05% and the next one is crop rotation to be followed. And next one is mites. Rhizoglyphus species, this is the these are very small insects. They remain mostly on the under surface and they suck the sap of the leaf. Affected plants become pale yellow. Crop infested with mites give a sticky appearance. And control measure are expose infested bulbs to sun for about 2 days and dust the crop with sulfur at the rate of 20 to 25 kg per hectare. These are the insect which are serious to the onion crop or affect the crop, and they reduce the production and productivity. Next one is diseases. What are the diseases to infect the onion field and onion crop? One is downy mildew, causal organism or peronospora destructor in humid atmosphere. The downy growth of the fungus develops over the entire and the leaf surface and seed stalk. In dry weather, only white spot appear on the older leaves and the infection spread to the seed and seed stalk. Plant growth stunted, leaves become distorted and pale green. Control measures are spray the crop with any fungicide like Genep, Mancozeb and Nabam Dithenium 45 at the rate of 0.2%, Ditolatin 0.1% after about 20 days of the transplanting of the seedling, and repeat the spray at 10 to 12 days interval. And next one is onion smut. Causal organism of onion smut are Eurocystis sepali frost. The fungus attacks at all the stages of the plant growth. Dark brown streaks seen the leaves and stems. The bending and twisting of the earlier infection leaves also occurs. Plants die within 3 to 4 weeks after. Control measure, treat the seed with Thiram or Kapton, or seed treatment with the Thiram or Kapton at the rate of 2 to 3 gram per kg seed, and treat the soil with fumigants like methyl bromide 1 kg per 25 square meter or formaldehyde. And the next one is a purple blotch or Alternaria porae. Alternaria porae, it is a purple blotch, is a very serious disease of onion, and incidence start with appearance of the water soaked areas on leaves and seed stalk, and soon they become brown in color and later purplish in center. Moist weather condition are favorable for the purple blotch, and severity of disease causes falling leaves and seed stalk without forming seeds. The bulbs of the affected plants may rot later. Prior to sowing, treat the seed with fungicide like Thiram 2.5 gram per kg seed. Spray the crop with Minab, Nabam, Genep at the rate of 0.25% at 10 to 12 days interval. 3 spray will control the disease. Next, black mold of onion. This disease causes great loss of onion bulbs in storage. You know, this is the storage disease. The causal organism is Aspergillus species. The infestation starts from the top, that is a cut portion above the neck, and any injury present oil and bulb. The affected tissues become water soaked, and at first a white mold develops between the scale, which follows development of the black spots on stalk, which can be seen with naked eye, and this mass remains on exterior of the scale, can be easily rubbed off. For its control, clean the stores properly and check the sufficient ventilation. The temperature should be below 15 degrees centigrade. Neither any variety is resistant to the black mold, nor any effective methods is available to check the infection in field. Next is bacterial soft rot. Bacterial soft rot or causal organism of Pseudomonas aeruginosa or Pseudomonas sepacea or Arvinia carotora cause soft rot. The onion bulbs are affected by bacterial species in storage. In fact, soft rot start in the field when crop approaching maturity stage. Affected scale become slimy and giving out a foul sulfurous smell. They enter the bulb through wound. Control measure or similar precautions should be taken by this black rot, and these are the insect pest and diseases. And last one is storage. What are the storage practices? In brief, for storing the bulb which are immature, injured, soft and thick naked should be sorted out. You know, there are different category of the bulb should be sorted out, and care should be taken that all the bulbs for storing are perfectly healthy and quite dry. Onion bulb store well at 0 to 1 degree centigrade temperature and 65 to 70% relative humidity. And the chances of sprouting of bulb in storage will be negligible if spray of mylic hydrazide at the rate of 5 ppm is done 15 days before transplanting. Generally, onion bulb of kharif season crop do not store well. However, handling of the kharif onion is not big problem because its production is limited. Kharif onion is taken by Maharashtra, Gujarat, Karnataka state in India, and that too on limited area. So this is the cultivation practices or production technology of onion, and this is the different grading, storing, storage, and all the factors are discussed here. And if any queries, please discuss to me. Thank you very much.